My humble pranams and prayers to speak of God. Dear brothers and sisters, I am not able to believe that I am in Delhi, because it has been one time a dream that has taken a shape, finally. Let me first say, the bhajan standards of Delhi are very, very high. I would rather say they are second to none. They are second to none. And the instruments, singers, both ladies and boys here, have been doing best of the job ever possible. Let me bless this group more and more. Let the group increase. In the years to come. And my experience in Delhi, the cold weather is something really challenging. I don't say killing, but challenging. I am not used to this kind of climate. But however, since my daughters are there in US, I spent one winter there. That made me to decide not to go visit that country again during winter. But in case of Delhi, it's not the case. In spite of cold weather outside, your warmth of love is keeping me quite warm. The kind of response we have been getting center to center, the sort of interest evinced by all of you in listening to Swami's experiences is very encouraging, thrilling, and exciting. May Bhagavan bless you. I also had occasion to listen to various activities in Delhi, which are quite novel, unique, and very special. May you continue the new areas of service to be closer and closer to Swami. The topic that has been announced is glimpses of divinity. I have been giving talks in a sequential order. So, following the same sequence, continuing where I stopped yesterday, we have few more episodes from in my life journey. In fact, I wanted to speak on Swami's message, and I was under the impression that you metropolis city people will appreciate message and all that. But you are on par with us, that you want to listen to stories and experiences. Okay. I only supply that what you want. I am at your demand and command, with no option left. What you want, I must serve, that's all. Towards the end, I shall take this point a little bit towards the end. Long back, I had been to a place by name Karimnagar in Telangana. Karimnagar is a place of communists, Naxalites. They don't talk, they'll just finish you off, that's all. Somehow, as state president, I went there. Believe me, at every stage they were stopping the car. And police peeped through the window to find out who is traveling. Thank God they did not choose to shoot me on the spot. They're checking like that and sending me, yes, you may go. Why? There is Baba's picture in the car. Perhaps Baba might have said, allow them to go, that's all. Don't disturb. Everywhere, at every point, I completed that meeting that day and returned. I came for Baba's darshan in those days. Every month I used to visit Prasanthanalaya. When I sat there, Swami came close and said, you have no common sense. Of course, it's not a news to me, as I don't have. Because William Hazlitt, the writer of English literature, who defined common sense like this: common sense is a rare and an enviable quality. So common sense is so uncommon. So doesn't matter if Swami says, I have no common sense. Good. I said, Swami, what happened? Then Bhagavan tells, did I not ask you not to travel after 10 o'clock? Why did you travel that way? I had to follow your car throughout the night. I had no sleep. And the police have got permission to shoot immediately anyone, whosoever, the suspect. You'd have been finished. Be careful hereafter. So nice to hear Swami protecting me. At the same time, I want to make Swami smile. My job, both in Vrindavan and Prashantalayam, is to make Swami smile. Because all of us go with bundles of letters, and bundles and complaints, by joint pains and cataracts, they'll be there. If not December, you'll have in January, that's all. So I never brought to his attention any one of my physical problems or psychological problems or family problems. Never, 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 ever. I never wrote to him any letter, nothing. But just let God be happy. Swami, 100 people give you letters of complaints, letters of requests and desires. Let me not be 101. No, I don't want to be that way. So when Swami said, did I not warn you not to travel at 10 o'clock? Thanking Swami for protecting me, then I added, Bhagavan, does not matter, you were with me at that time. You made me experience a miracle. Thank you, Swami, he said. It will not happen again if you are not careful, he said. So that way, the experiencing miracles started. At another time, I visited another place by name Sirsilla. Sirsilla is a place which is a matter of threat to the government. They give you the date and send you to the other planet. It's not like Indian Airline and Indian Railway. May 5th, you'll be no more on 6th, that's all. That is the place of that area. I went there. But along with me, I took one gentleman by name, Subramanya Sharma, principal of a college there from Visakhapatnam, Mrs. Avian College, principal, a great devotee. Sir, please come. Both of us went there, participated in the meeting. On the way, we had to catch the train at Kajipet, which is railway junction. The station master, Superman, by name Mr. Reddy, he came out of his office and said, Anil Kumar, I'm sorry, I could not attend your talk because I'm on duty. Would you like to have some tea in my office, he said. Why not? Coffee and tea is my weakness. Immediately I went in. He served me hot coffee. And then I started speaking on Swami to that gentleman. He was listening to me, glimpses, very happily. Then suddenly I thought, is it time for a train? Sir, 9:30 I must go. On inquiry, he said, sir, train came and left. But what will happen next day is a working day. That too, I was working in the Christian college. Iron discipline, you cannot bluff. Impossible. What am I to do? I came out, and this principal whom I brought started blaming me. Anil Kumar, you are not only in risk, you have put me also in risk. Now I decided not to travel with you once for all. I said, I'm sorry, sir, excuse me. This is the first and the last time, please, sorry, sir. We were discussing like that. Believe me, Swami is a living witness. This is recorded. in my books. This I narrated in the divine presence of Swami repeatedly. Therefore, its authenticity, credibility will never be questioned unless one is of questionable character. So, somehow, both of us were in hot discussion. Believe me, the train left, crossed the signal post. When both of us were discussing seriously, the train started reversing. Back to the platform, In those days in Andhra, Godavari Express is the fastest express. We don't expect the express to be reversed like that. Both of us got it. Somehow I could escape from that trouble or the trial, whatever you may call. And then when I came to Puttaparthi, Swami says, "You have no time sense. You will not only lose job, you will make others also lose their jobs.
You won't lose the job, it is enough."
What the hell you are doing? I had to reverse the train for your sake. Be careful hereafter. But that's really marvelous. Very kind of you to have done so. We had the Silver Jubilee celebrations of Sathya Sai Seva organizations. Silver Jubilee celebration, grand gala celebration across the state. At a time when I was the state president, naturally I was traveling length and breadth all over the state. At one stage, when N.T. Ramarao, the then Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, stepped down from his position and Governor Ram Lal appointed Nadella Bhaskar Rao in the place of N.T. Ramarao as an interim Chief Minister, and the whole state was burning because most of them are followers of N.T. Ramarao. Buses are burned, lorries are burned, complete bung. They just made all the logs of wood on the road so that nobody can go. I was to go to a place by name Palakollu in West Godavari for Swami's program. How do you go? No transport. Praying to Swami, somehow we engaged a van and we started moving. With Swami's bhajans there. By the time we came to Vijayawada, the present capital in the process of Andhra Pradesh, our communists they lined up with very big flag, double my size, tied up to the motorcycle, like they stopped the car. "Where are you going?" I said, "Sir, we must go to Palakollu." "No Pala, no Kollu. Then I'm going to go back." Did you not hear the news item? Did you not read in the newspapers that the state observes month today? No, why? But, so, I there in the van, I started singing that, "Swami, you should only protect." Somehow we could, when those leaders left, we could go a few steps, few yards, one furlong. Again they stopped. Slowly, slowly, at snail's pace, we are moving. Suddenly their leader came, top man. Well, that personality, well built in the muscle power. One would feel better we don't stand in front of the fellow. He suddenly stopped his motorcycle and said, "Where are you going?" "No, go back." "Okay, sir." Then he peeped into the car and saw Swami's picture and walked out and said, "I'll be standing here, sir. I'm CPM leader in charge to see that Bandh is observed 100%, that no vehicle should move, and here you go now." Nobody will stop. I went there. funny thing is, by the time I went, the meeting was scheduled around in the afternoon or so, but we were so late, it was 5 o'clock or 6. What to do? Most of the people were literally going home. How long can they wait? But listening to the bhajan, Anil Kumar is here. They started running back to the temple premises. Men, women, children running back. I went there immediately without any rest or cup of coffee. I just straight went to the dais, started speaking. As I speak about Swami, I lose all sense of time, even in front of Bhagavan. That happened many times. Once he even said, Anil Kumar, I'll ask you to speak tomorrow also. For today. There are times when he said, bus, enough for today. And then I remark, Swami, it's not my mistake. Your message is so sweet. Your experience are so wonderful. One cannot control Swami. Since you wanted me to start with one more episode, I'll start. He could bear with me, he could tolerate me. That's a wonder of wonders till this day. So, all people ran and I was speaking there. I received a slip from the audience. What is that slip? In an hour's time, here in this temple, a marriage is to take place. The bridegroom party, bride party are here. They have to make arrangements. Kindly conclude your talk as early as possible to perform a marriage of my daughter. Your assembly, bride's father. Well, what I did was, I read out that letter loudly in the mic. A letter from the bride's father says that I should come. Godavari districts in Andhra Pradesh taunt devotees. You cannot joke. You cannot enter Swami in singular person. Godavari, most favorite districts of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Most favorite districts. They are number one in devotion, number one in sacrifice and service. Why? For all national conferences, for all international conferences, rice, vegetables, oil, they are all sent by Godavari districts of the Andhra. All are sent by Godavari district devotees, such as staunch, powerful devotees. One fellow got up. Godavari has got a slang. Every district has got its own pronunciation, diction. In Godavari, style of expression, he got up and said, "What will the regal of that? What a problem of that? Chapane, Swami has it only chapane. I would have to lose from down." What is it was this? Should not the couple bless? Should they not lead happy married life? You continue your lecture. You'll enjoy Baba's blessings. Come on, none can stop you, carry on it. Really, a very nice experience. It only speaks of people who have grown above their personal things. Because most of us are bothered about the personal matters. My personal needs, my requirements, my prospects, my family. Then Baba, if I have time. Godavari districts are not like that. Baba first, anything next. That's all. I've been visiting those districts for the last 45 years. It is not my native place. My in-laws do belong to that place. But I should call a spade a spade. A fact of facts. That's what I noticed there. Quite amazing. And there's one place by name Kovuru, of West Godavari, quite close to Godavari River. I have come to know, straight from the district president, a very interesting situation there. What is it? It was May 6th, Iswarama Day. As you know, Iswarama Day, whole thing is carried on right from Nagar Sankirtan till cultural programs. Balavikas children will take charge of every item of the program. So Balavikas children are busy. They did Nagar Sankirtan that morning. They had bhajan sometime. And then Narayan Seva. Children should serve. While children are serving, a railway porter came there with a khaki knicker, blue shirt, and a red turban, typical uniform of a railway porter. He came there. He stretched his hand and asked the children, please serve me some food. Immediately they gave him this yellow rice and also pongal, sweet rice. This is recorded in my books. This I narrated in front of Bhagwan. Why should I tell this repeatedly? To establish his credibility, authenticity, accountability, ready for verification, that's all. It is not a story generated or developed as being done somewhere else. I am not bothered about it. This subject verification, recorded in all books, and in your house number, door number also. So, the porter stretched his hand, they gave him yellow rice and sweet rice. Porter ate, went to the tap, washed his hands, had water, and started moving there. At that time, two people were in charge of the Sai Center. One is Manchiraju Surinayana Murthy. Manchiraju, very well known to Ramanarayan Rao, maybe his relative also. Manchiraju Surinayana Murthy, he was the district president, and other man is the secretary. Both of them. Emerald Swami Hyderabad is his son only. I am telling you, because some doubting comes, idiots will be there. They'll be doubting. Therefore, I have to say again and again these addresses and the names so that you'll have to necessarily believe. If you still doubt, samshay atma vinashyati. If you doubt, you'll be no more tomorrow. I did not say Bhagavad Gita said. Don't be angry with me. Be angry with Bhagavad Gita and Lord Krishna. So, they were discussing, Surinayana Murthy and the secretary. What were they discussing? Why many people are not coming to our Sai centers? Why many are not participating in Sai bhajans? Why many don't turn up for service activity? Why? They were discussing. This porter came straight to those two people, called loudly, "Hey, Surinayana Murthy," railway porter, by name. Suppose if any fellow comes here and says, "Hey, Anil Kumar, what will happen?" Unless my life is insured, it's not an easy thing to bear that. But a porter called that, "Hey, Surinayana Murthy, what are we talking? You are the president, he is the secretary. You are discussing that bhajan, people don't attend bhajans. First, do you attend? You say that they don't attend service activities. You never attend service activities. You also said Nagar Sangeet attended in this sport. You never attended Nagar Sangeet. With what face you are talking about that?" shouted the railway porter. The Surinayana Murthy, the devotee of Bhagavan, he did lot of work in Srikakulam and Vijayanagaram districts, extensively established so many Sai centers. By this dialogue, you could understand it is not the water. Swami must have come in that form. Or what guts he would say, Surinayana Murthy? Immediately he ran home, opened almirah, picked up two Sikh dhoti, thought, he wanted to present to Swami. He just correcting them. His wife came inside. "What are you doing?" okay, I'm going to see this. She said, in love people are thinking man. Now I have to declare we are 100% man. What? Baba coming here and you are, you see? He said, shut up, enough is enough. He ran in there, and then gave the silk to the railway porter. Note this point. That year in November, Baba's birthday time, Swami said on the dais, nobody should give me dress. Nobody should give me any presents for my birthday. Don't bring clothes like that. He said, open on the dais that November. This happened next year May. Baba in the farm where worker shouted, what? Did you not attend my birthday? Did I not tell you not bring clothes like that? Take care. So this man is left with no option other than to open both the taps of his eyeballs and cry, both the president and secretary crying chorus together. What is to be done? Swami took those two silk robes. Sunanute, since you have given me, yes, I'll do what I can. So saying, he walked and gave to a very poor man, very elderly man, the silk robes, and so speaking, he vanished from there. There's a proof to say that Bhagavan can take any form, any time, any. It's only for us to take it. It's only for us to be ever vigilant. Then we have to be ever careful. That's what happened in Kabul. These have not been published in books, though they are, I have written my books which are published, being by SSSSO Books and Publication Division. So amazing, amazing things happened, I tell you. As a young man introduced me, said, Sikh, he made a mention of Sikakulam. As state president, I went to Sikakulam. There's one girl by name Uchyalama, MSc in Zoology. She married bank officer at that time. They must have been happily settled at Vizag with grandchildren by now. Well, she was the convener, Maida Vibhag convener, MSc Zoology. Well, I went there, Amma, you're so young, MSc Zoology. What made you to come to Swami? How is it that you are Maida Vibhag convener? Why, at this age? Then she told me, she is the daughter of Bhagiratha of Srikakulam advocate. Baratam Street. Okay? Still you want details? Come on! I'm ready to give you. Then what happened? This girl started telling me, sir, I was to be married. I took my wedding card to Swami. Swami looked at it and said, I will attend there. Swami attends wedding in Srikakulam of all the people. The backward district. Poor girl, she believed in all faith. On the wedding day, whole ceremony is taking place at a fast rate while this girl is looking there and there. Is there anyway Baba around? Thank God, it has not gone to the notice of the bridegroom party so that they would think she is a crazy girl. And then she comes like that. And she has not found you. Swami anywhere. Then lunch started. Lunch started. Then ask anybody in that district. When lunch started, there is a very big container of payasam. Payasam, you know? Okay. I should pick up some interesting words from you. A very big container full of payasam. They were about to serve. Believe me or not, their Swami smiling appeared there in the container. Bless you. It's not a vision. It is not a dream. It is not a hallucination. It is not an imagination. hardcore reality 100%. All people lined up and saw all people. And Swami's blessing has remained this last spoon in the container. That is Bhagavan Sri Sathya. It's taken like that. Do not take it in a casual way. Depending on the intensity of your faith, depending upon the gravity and the magnitude of work that you turn up, sincere work you do, it will be rewarded thousandfold by Bhagavan Sri Sathya. But if we don't get expected results, it only means something wrong with us. If a fellow failed successfully in the examination, fellow failed successfully, who is responsible? Is the teacher responsible? That idiot never studied. He failed. Similarly, when our wishes are not fulfilled, when our desires are not fulfilled, something wrong with our sincerity. Nothing with Bhagavan Sri Sathya Baba. Nothing. Because that hand is ever living, ever loving, ever giving, ever protecting hand. Abhaya Hasta, Varada Hasta, Bhagavan Sri Sathya Baba. This happened there. In the same district, there is a place by name Palasa. Palasa is a railway junction known for cashew nuts. They export cashew nuts overseas also, particular. Palasa, railway station master by name Narsimham at that time. That man is interested in temples and all that. He took Swami's permission and got ready a temple for Swami in Palasa. That temple was to be inaugurated on such and such a day. But no Nadaswaram is available. No priests are available. Because that day, Shankaracharya from Kamakoti Peetham visited that place. Some Ayyappa Mandir inauguration was to be held that day. That also an auspicious occasion for weddings to take place. So all priests are very busy. All Nadaswaram batch fully busy. Sathya Sai Mandir inauguration. This Narsimham, station master of Palasa, that he just stood in front of Mandir, praying to Swami. Swami, we are helpless. What are we to do? Then there come four priests. One is an okay. And there came Nadaswaram people, six of the troop. He welcomed them, very good sir, please come in. The whole function went on excellently. All devotees attended. In the beginning, completely empty. Later, all full, all full, all full. That is such a sad hour. At the end of the function, this Narsimham wanted to give money to these priests and Nadaswaram, as it is a routine matter. When he is about to give money, none of them are there. None of them are there. No Nadaswaram there. Now, pray. And he was asking everybody, we are to report those fellows. Do they belong to our place? No, sir. Have you seen them any time? No, sir. Where have they gone? We do not know, sir. Evidently, my friends, I have given the addresses also, including the name of the state master, who after retirement settled in Vijayanagaram. That's the mom. Well, he said, Baba has come as four priests and six Nadaswara musicians. 4 + 6, 10 forms. Baba has taken 10 forms to make his function successful. But we don't want to listen to these things. We are not prepared to believe these things. But while in Bhagavatam, when it is described by Potanamacharya in Telugu, or Vedavyasa in Sanskrit, that Krishna has taken forms of many cowherds. He has taken the forms of many cows and protected everybody. Amma, amma, amma. This can happen now. Sathya Sai Baba. It is only the action replayed, I tell you. Action replay. Arke, rewind. That's what I have found there. Life, we are not fools to follow Baba like that. We are sufficiently educated people. Sufficiently. We are not fools to follow him. But what happens is, the monkey mind, it goes on down. It has firm faith in the morning, half in the afternoon, nil by night. The day begins with yoga, wah! Patanjali yoga, wah! Pranayama! The whole day is spent in bhoga, money making. By night, roga, blood pressure and sugar. So the whole day revised just goes around these three: yoga, bhoga, and roga. In order to get off these things, let me tell you what Swami said. Anil Kumar does not know anything more than what Baba said. I am not tied to repeat 1,000 times even more, because I am a student of botany. Well, I am not here to quote Sanskrit verses, no. I should tell you what Baba said directly. Hot from the oven served to you. You understand that? This is what had happened. We believe that what all that happened, that all described in Bhagavata, that is replayed here right now. Another episode, that boy is here, where is that boy? Who played Kanjali? Adele? Ah, his father is from Nellore district. I know his father is a boy. Now he has got a big boy. I don't know when they are grown up. Why am I pointing out for your verification? Nellore district, there is very popular writer all over the state by name Deepala, Pichaya Shastri, great powerful writer, very short man. Swami always used to say, Pichaya Shastri, who is taller than the other? Am I taller than you? Are you taller than me? But he said, Swami, where am I, Swami? No, no, Pichaya Shastri. Because of my hair, I look taller than you. When you accept it, defeat, he will make you win. If you claim the win, throughout life you have to face humiliation. That was the means. That picture has a great writer. Used to visit Prashantali many, many times. Quite an elderly man. Swami necessarily talks to me. Because he's a great scholar. When we came to Vrindavan, I was there at that time. To see that I would draw Swami's attention, I was holding his hand, trying to take him inside. Though he was refusing, Anil Kumar, I can walk, why do you hold it? I want Swami to see. Service, whatever. Let me have publicity before divinity. Why not? So holding his hand. And Swami came, straight away spoke to me. To him, and ignored me totally, as if I am a mosquito or man. Everything has been put, you know. Such a man he is. Swami visited Nellore district, Nellore Sanjeeva City residence, and ministered endowments, arranged dinner in honor of the visit of Swami. All people, TV, MLAs, MPs, everybody sat there. Swami asked Pichaya Shastri, get into the car, let us go for dinner. When the car is speeding ahead, Swami said, let us go this way. Swami, this is the way, Swami. No, no, let's go this way. Where shall we go, Swami? I want to come to your house. Swami, nobody at home, Swami. My wife also is invited for dinner. Nobody at home, what can I do? No, no, I said that. I never said that your wife is a kid. I say that. I only said, I want to come to your house. He opened the door. That old lady is not there. Swami went straight to the kitchen. Ah, he ఏం చేసింది పొద్దు ముసలమ్మ? వాట్ ప్రిపరేషన్ షీ మేడ్ దిస్ మార్నింగ్ ఇన్ రాయలసీమ ఫర్ మార్నింగ్ తెలిసే పొద్దు ఈ పొద్దు మీనింగ్ దిస్ మార్నింగ్ ఏం చేసింది వాట్ హ్యాస్ షీ మేడ్ దిస్ మార్నింగ్ ఏమో స్వామి తిన్నాను మర్చిపోయాను ఏట్ ఐ ఫర్గాట్ దెన్ స్వామి ఓపెన్ ది లేట్ స్పీనాచ్ స్పీనాచ్ తోటకూర ఉప్పు చేసి ఈ స్పీనాచ్ షీ మేడ్ సమ్ ప్రిపరేషన్ పార్క్ ఈజ్ లెఫ్ట్ స్వామి ఓపెన్ ది లేట్ కెప్పట అప్పా వెరీ టేస్టీ వెరీ అండ్ దెన్ హీ వెంట్ స్ట్రెయిట్ టు ద పెండాల్ where dinner is hosted in his honor. Because everybody saw the student said, my dinner is over. You have it, my dinner is over. Are you not reminded what had happened in Bhagavatam? What happened? When Durvasana, accompanied by his people, wanted to test Draupadi. When he said that you come there and lunch there, Draupadi left with nothing. But Krishna had peace settled once for all. That had happened there in Nellore, where a direct witness to that. Long, long back, national conference was held at Rajmundry. Jogarao said, Swami, national conference at Rajmundry? There are only jet cars, only rickshaws. These people to come there, Are Yoga Rao, you will see. You shut your mouth like, okay, I'll do that. You ask anybody, the national conference at held at Rajmundry is a record, even today. In service, 6 feet, 6 hearts. What are rich people? They don't give you water to clean your feet there. Coconut water. They don't give you water to drink, coconut water. Very rich people, rich heart also. And then, why I'm telling you is this. Huge pendal, big company, Swami was speaking there in that pendal. The another pendal, lunch and dinner for me. 2,000 divorce or 3,000. Behind them, cooks, cooking process. Swami was giving a talk there. You ask anybody from Rajmundry. While giving a talk there, Swami appeared in the kitchen and gave darshan to all cooks. What did he say? When they came for my darshan, I have come here to have your darshan. Why should I say that? Wherever his service is undertaken, wherever his work is done sincerely, there Baba appears, understand. Long back, when Sikulon Thrai was the state president, when Swami was here, I followed him. Like Subharatan and Ananta, they were all in the convoy. We were all there. Oh, 100 cars behind. Swami suddenly said, let's go this way. Where? He went straight to a place where chapatis and parothas are made. Appu, more than any steel factory, salam factory or junction. At least you hundreds of ladies, chapati rolling in arm. Swami said, they are doing rock. I want to see them. I want to bless them. Swami went there. These ladies are sincere everywhere, either in cooking or in praying. They were just pressing all that. They didn't notice Swami. I was there. Swami said, Lovely Amma, then Sai Baba is your question. He has introduced himself by Sai Baba. And they just jumped in joy. Clap, clap, munch. చాలా సంతోషం ఎంతో బాగా చేస్తూ ఉన్నారు ఎందరు వస్తున్నారు స్వామికి ఎంతో ఆనందమైంది చాలా మంచిది బంగారు స్వామి ఇస్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ యూ హావ్ డూయింగ్ ఐ హావ్ బీన్ డూయింగ్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ వర్క్ దట్ ఈస్ సచ్ సాయి బాబా దట్ ఈస్ సచ్ సాయి బాబా అపీరింగ్ సైమల్టేనియస్లీ at the same time, to think Swami does not know, he is not here, he is not there, meaning you are not there. Please understand clearly. He can be anywhere, he can be anywhere. It was cyclone, Divisima, cyclone unheard. Thousands of people died there. Swami sent Sevadar from all over India. They were all doing service in that area. No electricity, no drinking water, no facility, dead bodies on the street. Who could do service like that? Only such a organization can do it. Government may submit the bills, that's a different thing. Only such a volunteers can go to the burial ground. They are ready to do that. I was there at that time. I was in the service camp at that time for one full month. Kasturi came on visit. When Kasturi came, we'd be thrilled, you know. We all had photographs with him. Where? Cyclone affected area. See the craziness of the man. Because we won't get Kasturi again. Cyclone will come every year. Then Kasturi went to Swami to report what had happened. Before he opened his mouth, Swami said, yeah, because Kasturi Vachanave, road anta kuda dead bodies. No drinking water, no food. There is no food, there is no drinking water. How could you go? Kasturi in his own style, Swami, I brought album of photos with me. I have a newspaper cuttings. Without looking at the album, he said, show me that photo where you are coming out of the hut talking to those victims of the cyclone. You spoke to those old people and came out. That photo, show me that. This is the service, he said. Why should I mention such a Sai Seva organization is not slow service, SLOW. If something happens today, we don't arrive tomorrow. Such an organization is not a show service, SHOW. It is not slow service. It is not show service. It is service 100% to the core. That's what such an organization is. That's what I remember of the SEMA. What wonderful activity they have done. At my own native place, Swami said, I will come. And he never came. What to do? All heads went there. Swami, you said that you will come, but you have not turned up. Atlana Bangaru, nenu vachinane, I came there. How am I to believe, Swami? I know that you are sweeping the floor, the ground, touching every inch with your palm, as doctor examines with the stethoscope. There will be pebbles, there will be thorns. That would pinch, Swami, you are examining that. I was feeling the heartbeat. I came there, why you doubt? That is such Seva. So to say, would he come? Would he come? He came already. Somebody was asking this morning, when will Swami come back? When will he come back? I said, he has not gone to come back. You have come, here you go. When you have not come, where is the question of going, returning? So when will he return? He has never gone back. Useless fellow, please understand. He is always here. That's what we have noticed there at several places. Then I take you, Tirumala. There was a doctor by name Lakshman Rao, eye surgeon, his wife, Dr. Revati, gynecologist. You can take notes and verify it. And the Balilkas convener by name Hamsaveni, who is the wife of general manager, State Bank. By name Venkateshwaran. And this lady, Hamsaveni, they hail from Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is very special. Their love for Carnatic music, their love for classical dance, their love for mother tongue, unequal, unparalleled, unbeaten. They have such love for that. And so the Samsarani is expert in playing on Veena. She has shown me, this is where Swami sits. There is a swing of Swami. Every day I play on Veena to make Swami to go to sleep. People are already thinking I am mad. By watching this, if I tell anybody, they will tell me, Anil Kumar, this is not the place for you. I took her as a crazy lady, quite mad lady. Miss Anil Kumar, you know, భోగి పడి అంటారండి హిందీలోను అంతకాదు సంక్రాంతిలో భోగి పడి పోస్తారు అది ఇక్కడ ఉందా ఐ అబ్జర్వ్ దట్ ఫెస్టివల్ ఆల్సో షీ సెడ్ ప్రిపేర్ ఫుడ్ ఫర్ స్వామి ఎవ్రీ నైట్ అండ్ గో టు బెడ్ దట్స్ వాట్ షీ టోల్డ్ మీ ఐ వాస్ క్వైట్ యంగ్ అట్ ద టైమ్ నాట్ దట్ ఐ యామ్ ఓల్డ్ నౌ క్వైట్ యంగ్ యంగ్ ఏజ్ is full of doubt, full of temper, full of ego, quite natural, quite natural. If you say that I have no ego, I have no temper, I am 25, you are dead and gone. That's quite natural. See, bitter fruit, unripe fruit, ripe fruit. Ripe fruit should be sweet, not a tender fruit. If it is sweet, throw it away. It's not fit for consumption. For pickles, do you make sweet mangoes? Yeah. Sour. So, I look at this lady, but I keep away from her. Because she may tell me a few more stories. I am not prepared to hear. After a month, in newspapers, Indian Express, on the title sheet, in a box, appeared the caption, Baba appears in Operation Theatre. Baba appears in Operation Theatre, Tirupati. I went on reading material. That Hamsavedi Balavikas Guru was to be operated. Doctors gave her a date. But this lady said, let me go to Swami, take his blessing permission, then I'll come back. You can operate. She came there. Baba said, I'll be there, don't worry. I'll be there, don't worry. It is her worry. Swami said, I'll be there. She was admitted to hospital. I repeat, Dr. Lakshman Rao, Dr. Revate, Tirupati, Ruya Hospital. Well, she was taken to the theater. All nurses, paramedical staff, anesthetists, they're all surgeons, they're all on duty. Come on! Operation started. All of a sudden, there appears Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. He started looking into her face. She started. In the end, all doctors saw. How is it Baba could come here? Why? But they could not question because if operation is stopped in the middle, she will kick the bucket. So they did not question him. They went on with the process, surgery, sutures, everything done. And by the time they turned back, Baba vanished. He fulfilled the promise. I will come there. That is Sathya Sai Baba. So many things happening everywhere. Karnool, don't think that I'm ignoring some areas. Karnool, Rayalaseema. Karnool, at one time the capital of every state. I went to Karnool and returned. There is a short story behind it. The day when I was supposed to go, on the previous night, heavy rains. All buses are cancelled. How to go to Karnool? How to go? I sent them telegram. Spoke to them. They said, Sahai sir, what can you do? Next, that midnight, I felt as if Swami is prompting. Why don't you go? How can I go, Swami? It is easy for you to say to go. Shall I walk up to the Karnool or what? Hold thy tongue. Go. I went to Karnool morning. Some of buses started resuming their service. I went to Karnool. Instead of talking to them in the morning, I had to speak to them in the evening. At the end of that, I came to Puttaparthi to see Swami. What does he say? Yera, yem ekkodam anukuntive? He wanted to escape. Swami's program, when once it is announced, it cannot be cancelled. You understand that? No program can ever be cancelled. Must happen. What do you think? You want to escape from that? I dragged you literally. You know that? Now the point is, you know why I interfered so much? That Karnool has one doctor by name Dr. Krishna Rao, the dentist. Swami said, Krishna Rao, chala old time devotee appa, night anta service chesevadu, first sevadal man, prachadalu chesevadu, nee raakapothe disappoint avutadu. Swami dikku kada andukane pampinchanu ayya. The doctor is the first sevadal man. He is to do night duty also. And if he don't go, he will be disappointed. I don't want to disappoint him. Therefore, I literally dragged you to that place. It's only to tell you, my friends, we cannot postpone. We cannot cancel. We cannot stay back at home. If we still do it, we have to pay heavily for it. We have to pay heavily for it. Because every service activity, every bhajan session is an investment in Sri Sathya Sai Reserve Bank, Sathya Sai. Everything will be given to you in double and multiples. Please believe me, please believe me. After all, we think bhajan is a music program. It is not. Bhajan is very important. Bhajan is very important. I was a skeptic. I never had any faith in anybody. Anybody. I went to one bhajan. Vijay Bhaskar, sir, Reserve Bank Vice President, old student college, now trust member, Vijay Bhaskar. He was a student that time. At his residence, I went there. First time, bhajan was going on. Kailasa Vasa Mahadeva, Jagadishwara Hara Mahadeva, Tribhuvana Pal Bab Sai Deva. Siva Maketra, Sai Ram, Siva Maketra, Siva Shankara, Siva Mahadeva, Sai Ram. His mother was singing with the pitch of her voice. What happened? I was looking at the picture of Swami. All flowers started swinging. Kailasa Vasa Mahadeva, Jagadishwara Hara Mahadeva, Tribhuvana Pal Bab Sai Deva. Flowers dance. Baba is the cosmic dancer. And then flowers started falling. Then I understood. Baba is a living divinity. Baba, a splendor, a glamour, an unbelievable phenomenon. He can reach anywhere. He can do anything. I was very, very happy. One engineer by the name Narasimha Rao, civil engineer, is stationed very close to recruitment office. I went to attend his bhajan with full of doubts in my mind. I am very much ashamed of my doubting mind in the past. I went there. The useless people asked me to give Harati. They should ask some good devotee to give Harati. But they asked me, a doubting man, to give Harati. What to do? I went there, started giving Harati. What happened? Narasimha Rao, civil engineer, while giving Harati, sound I heard. What is it? Amrit started falling from Swami's picture. Amrit falling on Swami. Are Baba, what a fool I am. What was my life in the past? What is it that I see today? There's a village of Reddys. Reddy is a powerful community, very rich people. Well, they invited me, I went there. And in villages, meetings are held at 8 o'clock. They'll go to the field, they do their work, they have their dinner and sit leisurely. You can talk till the morning. They are used to that life. When I was talking, one Reddy got up. Baba Sangha, hello. What rot you are speaking? You are speaking of Baba? Go home. Very powerful man holding a stick. Muscle of the size of big mango. A pumpkin size. If you use one dose, you remember for 10 lives to come. He was shouting, what you are doing? And I said, Reddy garu, this is our family function. Annual Seva Sathya Seva Samiti. We are having that function. I have come to speak. I am not forcing anybody to believe. Reddy garu, am I clear? Achapko, all right, go ahead. And he left. Later word, you know. All the office bearers have photograph. With Swami at the center, empty chair. That photograph is brought to me, they have shown me. Next to Swami chair, that Reddy sat. And Swami's chair is not empty. Swami sat there. And that Reddy constructed Sathya Sai temple in that village today. He constructed the temple. Full of thrilling. Full of experiences. Full of experiences. I tell you, when he sent me to Japan, that previous evening ice creams are served, he asked Balram to drive me to the airport. You were there at the school, 91, 92. So I was to go. So that morning I had all doshas sumptuously. Swami wanted me to eat more and more. As they are not available in Tokyo, or Kobe, or Osaka, or Hiroshima. So Swami made me eat those things. I went to the airport. Balram dropped me there and returned back to Whitefield. See the divine drama. An Indian airline, domestic flight, running late by 1.5 hours. Ah, 1.5 hours. So as per the timing, by the time I go to Bombay, I am not able to catch the flight Air India. I'll be missing it. International flights took a dot of time. But this Indian airline made my life like that. Swami, Sai Mahadeva, Patipureswaraya, Sai Bhava Maheshwaraya, Nirupama Kunda Sadhana, Sai Niraj Dalanayana, Vibhuti Sundaraya, Sai Bhava Maheshwaraya, Baba. How am I to go back? The boys give me send off. In an hour I have to go, please give me, welcome me now. Swami, what kind of ridiculous thing it is. Some of the flight came, I went to Bombay. Here in Vrindavan, Swami talking to everybody. Anil Kumar Velinadaya, flight Gantanara Leto. He went there flight, running late by 1.5 hours. I went to Bombay. Immediately there was an announcement, Anil Kumar. Last call. I ran and said, within minutes, he started. Take off. Swami was telling boys, ఫ్లైట్ పరిగెత్తుతున్నాడు రా, ఎలాంటి ఫ్లైట్, 5 minutes డిలే చేశాను వీడి కోసం అని. I had to delay for 5 minutes for this man. Swami, you delayed, you reversed the train then. Today you delay the international flight, Baba. Where are you? You are everywhere. That was the situation which I can never forget. About Japan, my friends, I tell you, the Japanese bhajans are worth hearing, full of discipline, same prasanthi tunes in Japanese language. They have mats there, they will sit on the mats, and books, Japanese book, bhajan books will be in front of them. There will be a board, page 12, song 6, page 14, song 7, according to that they sing. I never saw them with their eyes open, in deep meditation. Kamisama, Kamisama, Atena Uchinaro Kamisama, Kadirinai, Anino Ikarinde, Mitagide Kudasai, Kamisama, 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 Atena Uchinaro Kamisama, that is Japanese song, which I picked up there somehow, long back, 91. This song is, Bolo bolo sabme bol, omi yori bukai hai kum kamisam, I no kamisam, I no kamisam, omi yori la 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 la. What a wah, a wonderful sight for gods. And you may not also believe that those Japanese can recite Veda. About 300 of them came to Puttaparthi, you know that. 300 them. They are chanting for hours more. And Swami look at all of us. Yen chusinaru kada? Meekem ra? You don't see those fellows. Yem ra Swami ante? What do you think of Swami? You are just like a frog near the lotus flower. What do you know? See those Japanese. And during my subsequent visit to Tokyo, they organized a very big meeting attended by ambassadors of different countries. The Vedic Renaissance, Vedic Renaissance in India, all Vedic literature, including Upanishads, are being translated into Japanese language. That is Bhagavan Sri Sathya. Can you ever imagine that? It is going on, it is going on. That Hira is not a small man. Hira means a diamond, he is really a diamond. He is the main architect of Chaitanya Jyoti in Prashantanayam today. That is my experience with Japan. And there, I have been to Hong Kong, and Hong Kong president looks more or less like our Chima, white, tall, very handsome, of yellow mango complexion, with a serious face, nicely dressed, British style. A typical British people, they're always like that. And the president of Hong Kong Center was there. And in Kobe, one gentleman by name Ram Chugani, a Sindhi gentleman, he accompanied me to Hong Kong. Because I've got many relatives. Both of us sat there in the flight, Cathay Airline, Cathay Pacific Airline. I asked Ram Chugani, sir, do you think Swami is here in the flight? He said, Anil Kumar, I should put that question. It is not for you to ask me like that. What is it? Okay, sir, I'm sorry. Then in the flight, they give you some peppermint, some juices, some papers to engage yourself so that you will not be afraid of the flight. I would see some Discovery magazine. Discovery magazine is full of cameras, projectors, and everything, shirts, everything, sales, business magazine, all women and all that. I was just looking at them. Believe me, sir, Swami is the proof. I spoke in the presence of Swami these things that day. That's all videotaped, you can see that. At the center of the magazine, Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba, in the sitting posture, I saw that picture in that magazine. I asked you whether Swami is here. He is there, you fellow. Ramchugan said, Anil Kumar, you understand this? Okay, sir. Then I called that flight attendant. Can I have this magazine? Nobody will ask for magazines like that. She looked at me like a rustic fellow. He's a rustic fellow, village fellow. He wants a magazine, what's all this? Actually, it kept in a briefcase. Went straight to Hong Kong Science Center from airport. It was held in Kenny Chugani's house, his wife Renuka. I went there. In the course of the talk, Ram sat by my side. In the course of the talk, I said, look here at the miracle of Sai Baba. While I was doubting his presence in the flight, but what happens? His picture appears in the central page of the Discovery magazine. I showed to you. I opened the suitcase, picked up the magazine. Picture vanished. I could not see Swami pick this side, that side, 100 times I checked. I was still to stay there for 5 days. If the first opinion is that Anil Kumar is a bluff master, no one will attend my meetings. I'll be utter flop on the very first day. I looked at Ram Chugani pitifully. Sir, you should speak on my behalf. He got up and said, I am the proof, I am the witness. I saw Baba's picture. Don't doubt Anil Kumar. I saw that. What he said. After my return, back to Parthi, what did our loving God say? Yemappa, show chedam anukunnav. Show chedam anukunnav. Baba mahimalu, pradarshanalu kavayya, avi nidarshanalu telusko. You want to put up a show there? I am not here for show. Baba's miracles are not objects for exhibition. They are the proof of my divinity. You want to show it everywhere? That's why I made it vanish. That is the thing I remember. There's one president by name Harish Daswani of Hong Kong Center, you must have met him. What happens? They were about to fix the wedding of their brother, the youngest man. There on Baba's picture. Perform the marriage with the day, time appeared on Baba's picture. That is Bhagavan Sri Satya. So to doubt is Swami there, Swami. So we are fit for insanity, psychological problem. With all these miracles, with all these things happening all over the world, can we ever doubt it? We should not. I think, sir, I have taken more time than what you said. I have got a few more days to stay. And I want your cooperation. And I want to receive your nice smiles also. And I also hope that you would invite me again. Rather think that this man would not stop. Therefore, I honorably, respectfully conclude with a song. Come on, sing loudly.
आदिशेष अनंत शयना श्रीनिवास श्री वेंकटेश
Something like this: after sumptuous, delicious meal of sweet pudding, eating bitter curries. Muthanhalli is the development of few people who are there in Prashantalayam, who are brought up, who are encouraged, who have grown. They are in their premises, but as ill luck would have it, they had to leave and form a separate institution. Let me make few points. Baba makes people. Baba inspires people. Baba motivates people. He will not give me wood like that. Baba never solicited funds. It is going on there against the principles of Sai organization, against the basic philosophy of such a Sai. For in the history, it is only such a Sai Baba who made the whole world come to his feet. He has not gone anywhere. Whereas people elsewhere go around different countries and say you will collect funds in the name of Baba, which is really not acceptable by any standard. Further, Baba said, between you and me, love to love, heart to heart, I directly talk to directly, no mediators, Baba said very clearly. Unfortunately, the whole drama goes there in the name of mediators. Therefore, just opposite is going on there. But I would rather appeal to you. Your conscience is witness. Your fortune, your destiny will decide where you should be. I can tell you, my friends, confidently, the worst tragedy that can ever happen in our lifetime is to forget and lose Baba. Of Prashantinilayam. I cannot kidnap, I cannot transplant, I cannot abduct, I cannot hijack Tirupati and place it at my place. Tirupati is Tirupati. Vatican is Vatican. Prashantinilayam, the abode of peace of Bhagavan. So he is such a Sai Baba. It will continue to shine forever, ever, and evermore.